Brahms was on holiday in Bad Ischl in 1893 when he wrote this intermezzo. It is what he describes as teeming with dissonances. We wonder, are they dissonances to us now? But listen to this line of thirds. For Brahms, this was very special. He chose the key of B minor, which he had written the clarinet quintet in 2 years earlier. Rather similar thirds again, B minor. Let's listen. Here we have parallel thirds. He writes that he wants every bar to have a ritardando, as it were, to linger on the music, on the falling of each of these tendernesses. Here we go again. Enters a different little melodic fragment, a tentative one, answered immediately in the left hand. And then flowing more confidently through. Major chord. We now move straight into the major key. We've left the sadness, the regrets of B minor. D major. All the rising, the thirds upwards this time. We're falling down before, upwards, and by step. The rhythm to the sideways it a bit like a little rocking for the cradle song. Let's go to explain the first phrase. Opening, expanding, pushing at the door, wider and wider, the sun has come out, stretching again but receding, the sun is setting by steps. Back into gentle D major. It's a moment to gather breath. Typical thirds, stretching again. Stretching the rhythm like a written out ritardando. And then, just as a little preface to the return of the main theme, we get a cluster of thirds, but he pushes them together, two in the bar instead of just one, a hemiola. Mm-hmm. gathers balance for an extra treat, a little tucking underneath, like tucking the child's napkin in. And then as before, diminished. Now here it comes, gentle, so tender. Another descent of thirds. Have to continue. And a final lift before the falling thirds. There's a dissonance. Now resolved into a double minor third. Listen the whole way through. Clara Schumann, to whom he sent this piece, wrote back, "It is like a gray pearl."